Sylvia, give us some insight as to what's moving, what's not, how we're set up for the second quarter.
Hi, Alex. Good morning. So there are definitely some corona economics in the markets, and I think, you know, when we take a step back and look at the markets, we see valuations globally looking fairly attractive and pretty low. You know, you can't call the bottom, but if you have a long-term time horizon, there are some bright spots out there. Some of the flows that we've seen recently have been into places like healthcare, you know, ETFs that track healthcare companies and biotech companies, which, you know, could come up with potentially a cure or a vaccine or, you know, essentially something that will abate the coronavirus. They're flush with cash. They have strong balance sheets. And, you know, it's sort of been a late cycle performer anyway prior to coronavirus. So there are some challenges in the near future, but there could be some bright spots as we see, you know, what sort of comes out from that sector as it relates to the virus. Some other areas that we've seen interest in have been both consumer staples and consumer discretionary. So, you know, if you look at the recent shakeup of the select sector indices, if you look at staples, some of the top names in there are things like, you know, Procter & Gamble, you've got Costco, you've got, you know, some of these big bulge bracket stores that sell things like toilet paper. And, you know, what are people buying? They're going out and buying a whole bunch of things like toilet paper, tissues, you know, Coca-Cola. So all of those names remain, you know, heavy and strong. On the other side of consumer discretionary is Amazon. Now, consumer discretionary is something that you want more than something that you need in theory. But if you look at the names in the index, you know, Amazon being the top name there, what does Amazon sell? You've got everything from live streaming, you know, people sitting at home watching TV, buying movies. You've got the consumer staples in there. A lot of people are buying paper towels and toilet paper at Amazon too. And I think that, you know, they keep coming out and saying that they're hiring hundreds and thousands of workers. So obviously the demand is there, and we've seen the two flows. Viviana just mentioned it, that they've seen, you know, the market has seen a lot of flow into gold-related ETFs. We've seen the same on our side. So gold miners and flight to safety types of plays like flow into utilities, bonds, and gold-related ETFs. So, you know, I think investors, particularly with shorter horizons, are looking for the short-term tactical opportunities that are moving the market, which again are like staples, discretionary, gold, and longer term they're looking for you know, low valuations and entry points across all sorts of sectors like tech and semi that'll probably continue to do well into the future.
So Sylvia, with about a minute left, can you tell me about sort of the ETNs, the leverage guys, like which ones are wiped out?
So they're not, we don't have, you know, ETFs are wiped out, but in terms of, you know, coming off of highs, I mean, the names that brought us up into the you know, tops of the S&P 500 are the names that have been, you know, really hit the most. I mean, I'll start with really oil and energy, because those have been, you know, those have definitely seen a downturn, with 2020 being one of the worst year for oil since, you know, in decades. Basically, it's fallen 70% and yeah, quickly approaching, if it's not there, at $20. But also, you know, tech and semi in the short term, just because all the stores are closed, they're high beta names. And, you know, so look to those also, though, at low valuations for potential recovery when we get past this.